Doctors could be on the brink of a breakthrough.
Migraines.
How to control them.
Tame a migraine.
A severe migraine.
Throbbing, recurring headaches.
Given all the noise, navigating the migraine experience can be confusing and scary, but you do not have to do it alone. Welcome to the Migraine Guy Podcast, the official podcast of themigraineguy.com and theheadachereview.com. Now, here's your host.
What's up, podcast audience? It's Kevin here. Just wanted to let you know that this podcast, the Migraine Guy Podcast, is currently the only podcast dedicated to covering, informing, and discussing headache and migraine conditions. There are some older podcasts that used to produce weekly or monthly content that have stopped, and that leaves a gap in an area that is ripe for bringing awareness to the population at large. So if you want to help bring awareness about headache and migraine conditions, make sure to leave a review of this podcast and the episodes you've listened to. The higher the rating, the higher those algorithms in the different platforms rank podcasts. And so if you like this content and want other people who are searching for podcasts to listen to have this podcast suggested, then go ahead and give it a 5-star rating as well as a written review telling people why they should listen. Now, this isn't about me. I'm just one guy doing a little podcast trying to get some information out there. But the more people that listen to this podcast, the more people that are exposed to the information, the content that we talk about, the more people will know about headache and migraine conditions. And that is our goal. Well, it's one of our goals. The second goal is for you, the headache or migraine sufferer, to know that you are not alone. And so let's get started. What's up, pod-ience? That is my podcast audience. It's Kevin here, the Migraine Guy, bringing you a new podcast today about being a man and what that's like with migraine. Now, I just want to give you a quick update on the CBD oil that I mentioned in the migraine and marijuana podcast a couple weeks ago now. The vape pen and CBD oil I was waiting on did arrive. The quality of the material seems pretty high. The CBD oil claims to be organic. And so I'm just going to go ahead and start putting all of it to use and documenting its effectiveness or lack of effectiveness with regard to my chronic migraines over the next week or two so that I can bring you a full and detailed podcast about whether or not CBD oil from at least this particular company, Alternative Vibes, produces any beneficial or non-beneficial results with regard to my migraine. So keep updated by hitting the subscribe button on whatever platform you listen to podcasts. I'll be doing that podcast probably in about 2 weeks. I want to make sure that I give the CBD oil plenty of time, make sure I give myself time to get used to being able to use it when I notice I'm having migraines, getting used to putting it into my daily routine so that it can build up a little bit. All that kind of stuff needs to take a little bit of time. And so I'm thinking about 2 weeks for the CBD podcast. So make sure to keep updated for that. But today's podcast, as I said, is about being a male who gets migraines. Actually, I put out a little APB, not quite an APB because I wasn't looking for anybody, but I was looking for topics that you, the podcast audience, would want. And one reply I got on Facebook actually asked me if I would do a podcast about what it's like to be a male who gets migraines. And I thought that was a pretty interesting and honest question from someone. If you're not at all familiar with statistics on migraines, the basic understanding is that about 2/3 of migraine sufferers are female. And so that puts you as a male who suffers from migraines automatically in the minority of migraine sufferers. And that kind of statistic contributes sometimes to a misunderstanding that migraine is a female-only issue. It's a female-only problem. In fact, if you're kind of an ignorant man or an ignorant person who hears these statistics, you might think that migraine is only a hormonal issue. In fact, I've heard a sales representative of a particular ice-based therapy device say that to me on the phone, and it took everything I had in me not to, reach through the phone and smack him. But the idea certainly does exist that migraine is a female issue. And so if you are a male who says that you get migraines, you might face a certain, set of a particular conceptualization issues on the person on the part of the person you're talking to, maybe misunderstandings or maybe even some prejudice because of your gender in relation to your migraine disease. Now, I happen to be very lucky in that I have not actually, at least overtly, seen anybody say, well, you're a guy, come on, you don't get any migraines, come on, you don't have a menstrual cycle, suck it up, man. I've never had any of those circumstances, as I said, thankfully. Now, I, you know, do run a private Facebook group, getting ready to launch a forum on theheadachereview.com. And I certainly have heard from other migraine sufferers online, male migraine sufferers, that is, that they do receive some blowback from being a male who has migraine. They receive, you know, maybe a little criticism. They receive a little ostracization. They receive a little, you know, not necessarily joking, but kind of bullying perhaps from coworkers who have to cover shifts, who have to make up for their not being there because of their migraine conditions. And so it certainly is an issue that a male with migraines has to at least be ready to face. Now, this podcast, I guess, is going to be mostly first personal. I'm not going to be doing a lot of statistic and then some personal stuff like I have the last time, since the question posed on Facebook was about my experience as a male with migraine. My overall experience hasn't, as I said, been really negative. The thing that was interesting for me is that, for example, in my private Facebook group, the Migraine Guy Facebook group, I have found lots and lots of females who have joined the group say that they really enjoy hearing about what it's like to be a migraine sufferer and a male. They like the perspective of someone different than them from a gender that they don't have. And so I found that very welcoming. If you're not at all connected to the online migraine world, I would greatly encourage you to do so. There are a lot of compassionate migraine sufferers out there who can help you if you're feeling alone or if you are feeling ostracized, who can help you be connected and know that you're not alone. Additionally, there are a lot of male migraine sufferers out there. Even though 2/3 of migraine sufferers are women, let's just talk about the U.S., right? There's 30 plus million migraine sufferers, either episodic, infrequent, or chronic. And so that means that there's 11 million men out there, 11 million guys, 11 million males who are migraine sufferers. That is a lot of people. And so there are going to be a lot of male migraine sufferers out there. The thing that we need to do is be willing to speak up. You know, if you want to talk about your stereotypical guy, right, they're the kind of guy who's going to, you know, suffer silently, not want to talk about their pain, da 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 da. You have to get over that kind of ego, that ego problem where you're a guy and so you're just going to tough it out. You have to be willing to say, I have this condition and it's terrible. I have this condition, it sucks. I have this condition, it's ruined parts of my life. I have this condition and it is very difficult to deal with. You have to be willing to be honest if you at least want to find other people who can make you part of their community. It doesn't mean they're going to offer you a cure. No one in my, you know, private Facebook group or social media context get cures just by listening to me or me listening to them. But there is a very, very beneficial effect that comes when you're willing to group together and say, well, you have this and it sucks. You have this and it sucks. I have this and it sucks. Let's just have it and have it suck for all of us and we can talk about it. So I think that's probably the biggest thing I've learned is I'm certainly prone to not wanting to discuss my pain. I'm certainly prone to not wanting to tell people that I can't do something because I'm, you know, having a level 7 out of 10 migraine in terms of the pain scale, and I just can't even get up, let alone go out or complete the activity that I promised to complete. But that means that I can log into, you know, Facebook, log on to Twitter, log on to Instagram, post something and get a lot of feedback. And that has been really encouraging for me because it's been a way for me to not only get some sort of, you know, psychological benefit from complaining, it also allows me to see when other people complain, male or female, that I feel like I can do for them what they did for me when I was kind of at a low point. And so nothing that I'm saying in this podcast today directly relates to me being a male who gets migraines because I just haven't, as I said, gotten any of those negative responses. But if there was one single lesson that I have learned since getting chronic migraines, at least, and being the kind of person who typically represses their feelings, represses their desire to talk about what's bothering them, is that you do get a lot of benefit when you talk about what's going on. You don't have to talk about necessarily your quote feelings, but you can talk about the pain that you're feeling. You don't have to talk about how you feel about that feeling if you don't want to. What you can do though is just say, God, today sucks. I'm in so much pain and nobody understands. Or God, I had to call into work again. My coworkers are going to hate me. That kind of stuff, just a little one sentence blurb on whatever social media platform you prefer can help other people to say, hey, this person needs our help. This person is like us. They're a chronic pain sufferer. They're a spoonie and they need some uplifting. And so male or female, that is a very important lesson to take to heart, is that when you're feeling low, you need to just, you know, plop a couple thumbs down on your phone, punch out a short message, and hope that the people that are involved in your social media life will reach out back to you. So, as I said, this is not really anything directly related to being a male with migraine, but I think it's important for males to hear from other males that, one, it's important to tell others, at least a particular group of others that you trust, that you're in pain. Two, I think it's extremely important that you have a reliable group of people that you can tell that kind of stuff to. This is really a big benefit that I see to online support groups, to the internet in general, is that if you're in a context where your migraines really prevent you from getting out of the house, so maybe a face-to-face support group doesn't really work, and that makes it really difficult to connect with people, such that you couldn't even really get people's phone numbers to call them or text them because you can't really get out of the house, the internet is a great tool to help you connect with other people who are in similar circumstances to you. You can just go to Facebook, go to Twitter, go to Instagram, go to YouTube, type in your condition, migraine, fibromyalgia, whatever the condition is, plus the word support and the word group, and you can find thousands upon thousands of other people who are like you. And all you have to do is just drop one sentence, today really sucks, and you'll get a flood of positive comments, encouraging comments, and people who are like you, who are suffering in similar circumstances. Maybe they're not as bad as yours, but perhaps, and very often, they are much worse than yours, and those people are finding ways to get by, and you should put yourself in a position of learning. You should try to ask them, how do you do it? How do you survive day in and day out with debilitating chronic pain? Because I'm at my wit's end. So as a guy who gets migraines, that's the biggest takeaway that I can promote. It's not really gender specific, because I don't really have any blowback from my being a male who gets migraines. But there is a stereotype of, you know, males where they don't talk about their issues. There is another stereotype about guys where they don't like to hear from other guys being weak. And people who are in chronic pain, people who are involved in those communities know that those kind of stereotypes are BS. And know that not talking about their chronic pain is certainly one of the dumbest choices you can make as a chronic pain sufferer. And so that's the big encouragement from today's podcast, is just get into a group. It doesn't matter what kind of group, whether you're just like responding to a hashtag on Twitter and that puts you in connection with other people, or if you're in an actual support group on, say, Facebook, or you're involved on a forum, or whatever you're doing. If you're just replying to someone's YouTube video in the comments section, just getting your voice out there helps you to be in a better position to receive a little bit of community from people who are in that world and who know the benefits of talking about it. So if you're a guy who gets migraines listening to this and you're wondering, well, what's the one thing that I can do as a male who gets migraines, who gets chronic migraines? The most important thing you can do is talk about it. Somehow talk about it. Doesn't matter if it's typing, doesn't matter if it's friend requesting the migraine guy on Facebook and then sending him a Facebook audio file and saying, hey man, I just need some help. I'll respond, talk to other people, they'll respond. Just be willing to put yourself out there and wait for a reply from one of these groups. The benefit of community is that you stop being alone. As I'm sure you know, chronic migraine sufferers, chronic pain sufferers are at a much higher risk for things like depression and anxiety. And so if you are If you're suffering from migraine and you're also battling depression, that is just a terrible series of conditions to have to face simultaneously, because you've got the intense pain of migraine, plus you've got the emotional problems that go along with depression. You've got the isolation, the lack of motivation, and it can all make for this perfect storm where life seems pointless. And that's the most important time when other people matter. That's the most important time to reach out. And it's also the hardest time to reach out. I've known a number of people that have gone through depression, clinical depression, depressive episodes, suicidal tendencies. And the one thing that they all say is that talking about their issues, even though it's not a cure, right? It's not the moment you reach out for help, the skies are going to part, the heavens are going to sing, and everything's going to be rainbows and butterflies. It's just that it's the beginning of a process where you realize that you're not going to get through your condition unless you talk about it, unless you're willing to communicate with others. And so that is the number one thing that I think migraine sufferers, chronic pain sufferers certainly, but at least migraine sufferers need to be made aware of, is that if you're a male or a female, it doesn't really matter at this point, and you're feeling isolated, reach out. You can always hit up the Migraine Guy support group. You can always check out the Migraine Guy Facebook page or the headachereview.com. We're going to be launching a forum soon. It's going to have all sorts of discussion forum subtopics, a variety of things that I think are lacking online. There are very, very good migraine support groups online, but I think there are some things that are lacking, and the headachereview.com is going to try to fill that void. So if you're new to migraine, you're scared, make sure to just hit up all your social media sites that you like and just start searching for support groups with whatever chronic pain condition you have, and just reach out. Just say, I need help. And you'll be surprised at the amount of responses that you get from people who not only are in circumstances like yours, but know how to get through the rest of today. So I did say that this was going to be a podcast about what it's like to be a male with migraines. It's turned into a you never have to be alone kind of message, but that really is the message of this podcast. It's turning into the message of the Migraine Guy and the headachereview.com. And it's certainly a message worth repeating over and over, is that you are never alone. You never have to be alone. All you need to do is make the first step and type out a short message saying that you need help. And you'd be surprised. In fact, you might even be overwhelmed at the amount of support that you're going to get. So, as I like to do at the end of these podcasts, I'm going to ask you a question to reply to me on any of the social media platforms you follow me on. And so that question today is, what do you do when you start to feel depressed or alone, given your chronic pain conditions? I know a lot of people who listen to this podcast don't only get migraines. They have a lot of other chronic pain or habitual problems that they have to face with their body. They have to face with the genetic cards that they were dealt. And so I want to know what you do to get through those down times, what you do to stay motivated, to stay strong, to survive, because those are the kind of things that we need to hear about. So on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, or in the comment section on theheadachereview.com on this podcast, please leave a message about what you do when you get down, what you do when you're kind of blue, to make sure that you survive. And I will try to repeat a couple of those tips and cite you as the source for them in next week's podcast. Additionally, if you're not following this podcast, I hope that you'll hit the subscribe button, not because it's bringing me any sort of money or it's bringing me any sort of fame. What it does is the platforms that you listen to podcast on, iTunes, Stitcher, Google Play, TuneIn, Pocket Cast, all those, the more people that subscribe and the more people that listen, the higher this kind of content gets ranked in their algorithms. And that means that more people will be exposed to the message of this podcast. And the reason that's important is because there are a lot and a lot and a lot of chronic pain sufferers out there who need to be made aware that they're not alone. They just need to find the right outlet for their becoming part of a community. So that is the end of the podcast today. Really appreciate everybody who has been listening. We've seen a lot of growth the last few weeks that I've been doing this podcast, so I'm very encouraged and going to keep it going. Make sure to answer that question. What do you do when you're down in the dumps, when you're feeling blue, or when you're actually depressed? How do you survive? And what can you tell to other people to help them know that they are not alone? That's the end of the podcast. Take it easy, pod-ience.